urban ecotourism, farm tourism, rural tourism, so on and so forth. Now, the fascination of human being to seek human killings, to visit a Holocaust site, to visit a suicide site, okay, or to the dungeons, has created another concept of tourism, which is known as academically dark tourism or thanatourism. These are new avenues of tourism which has just developed a couple of years back academically. But you know, the concept is very old. This is a Colosseum, you know, where people used to visit how gladiators used to be killed. I've been informed in British Museum, one army personnel, Ajax, he committed suicide because he was not promoted to army, and a memorial has been set by the museum authority on a verse. So they have, they just smelled a kind of tourism scenario from that suicide. So you see, there's a suicide point in Australia where a message is there, hold on to hope, there is always help. Okay, so it is again a kind of tourism point. So now, all of you have heard the word euthanasia. Now, it is a Greek word, eu means good, thanatosis means death, it means good death. It is related to the concept of mercy killing, but euthanasia has been, I would say, clinically divided into two parts, active and passive. Active euthanasia means a doctor or maybe another person will inject a lethal drug or by other means kill a person who is ailing from terminal diseases or for other reasons. But passive euthanasia means withdrawing a life-saving devices of an ailing patient, or the doctors and the psychologists and the psychological counselors, they wait through the time so that the patient can pass away silently. So there's a difference. And this concept, I would like to deal with some historical fact. The word euthanasia has been first used, okay, by a Roman historian named Suetonius in order to describe the Augustus Caesar's death. Okay, in ancient times, you know, various civilizations look into the issue in various ways. For example, Greek physicians, they used to just apply euthanasia techniques by throwing away the babies or killing the, you know, the people who are not physically fit. But Assyrian physicians, they used to object on the issue. The first book named Utopia recommended euthanasia, published by Sir Thomas More. These are some historical facts. Now, what are the religious beliefs? It's very simple. You know, this concept has been coined with the religious beliefs. Islam is against euthanasia because, as per the belief, Allah is the creator of the life, so human being cannot interrupt. Now, Catholic Christians are against euthanasia just because they have a kind of mindset of abortion like that, but because it's a God's creation. Protestants are comparatively liberal. Sometimes they advocated euthanasia. In Hinduism, there are again two schools. One school say no, it is a kind of religious practice. In Mahabharata, the epic, Pandavas, they have went to Mahaprasthana, final saying. So it is nothing but indication of euthanasia. And on the other hand, some Hindu belief says that it is a sin. It cannot be practiced. Okay, so Jainism and other Shinto, they have a mixed views on this.